Theory, we should be live. We are. Edit. Woohoo! Okay, my mic is very hot. Hello? Okay, now it's better. Am I hearing myself? Let me adjust some things. Transform. Split screen. Can you go back to the settings, the system? Just so I can have the words. The crop again. All right, we're off to the races. Game title. I can hear you twice for some reason. Can you talk? Keep talking. You should be able to. I do not. Let me see if I keep talking. Okay, I fixed it. Cool. Alrighty. Let me do this. You can press new game. Finally. More options. We made it. Woo! All right, first choices. So, since I'm backseat gaming, I'm going to tell you everything about these. Are you using your controller? Yeah, cool. So, here's my recommendation. You look at the samurai and tell me if that looks interesting. Because that is, so between the samurai and the first one, which is the knight, I think, those are the best chances for someone new to the first, not the wretch, that's for advanced people. Not Vagabond. Yes, Vagabond. No, Vagabond. Is there a knight? Yeah, so either samurai or vagabond. Vagabond has like a long sword and a shield. Samurai has a katana that is really good damage that can get tight spots. Not much. Do it. Samurai is type A or type B is basically male. All right, so this is typical RPG stuff, naming your guy, gal. Yeah. All right, that's you might need to type on your keyboard. For keepsakes. I would definitely do Golden Seed. I'll tell you why later. If you want to mess around with how the guy looks, or you can go default. Like, there's a couple of templates that you can choose from. Well, yeah, but like if you end up changing your hat, your helmet to something that shows his face, I think it's worth it looking at some of the templates. You can. If you go to if you want to go through like the whole thing, or do you want to beeline to the beard? Yeah, it might be very subtle. Yeah, you don't have to go through all of these. These are like for super detailed sculpting, like you can see people that create Kratos from scratch and stuff like that using these, but you can go straight to like the main general features like hair and beard. Looking at three, yeah. Or you can back out and put match hair and change the hair color. There you go. Yeah, there's enough detail for anyone who wants to do so. Yeah, you're ready to go. Yeah, you can fix the placement of that as well, like in the tweak tattoo mark section. You can move it, grow it, flip it, do everything. No worries. By the way, video.ninja can be used for non-streaming purposes. Like you can send video to someone peer-to-peer. Like if you want to screen share very high res, you can just use it. Did you give him a name? I didn't notice. Really bad backseat gamer. Right. I would save it a favorite, in case you want to reuse that face or just save it. Yeah, you can press circle. Finish. Are you ready? You'll be very confused if you think the ring is an actual ring. It's a rune. None of this is going to make sense to you right now. Yeah. So intense, and with the right context, this is so powerful. But like, with this as the first thing you experience, you're like, I have no clue what's happening. That's you. By the way, your mouse is in the middle of the screen. Yeah. Not. Oh well. I'm gonna make it as if I didn't notice. Can you go to the gamepad button settings? Let's see if you can get the click on that. It's fine. We'll live. It's fine. You can get out. You should. Okay, it's gone. Perfect. Yep. You just press the circle and we'll dismiss it. So this is your equipment menu. I'll definitely be helping you out here. Yeah. I would remove the bow for now, just because it adds weight. And if you can see, there's you press the square button, remove it. Yeah. No, that's fine. Those are not weight. But there's a weight system where you have a max weight, and if you're under 70%, your roll is so like try rolling now. It's with the circle button. Yeah, you see it's nimble. If you remove more equipment, it'll be faster. So this is the triangle button. These are messages that this is people online who leave messages. Yeah. Getting acclimated with the controls. So when you see that's you're pressing square, right? Yeah. So square is use item. These are so your right mouse button. Are you, what do you call them? Right mouse button, or do you call R1? Okay, so R1 is your light attack. R2 is your heavy attack, and it's chargeable. L L1 is your block. So on the D-pad, if you press the left button to switch out to your shield, now you can block. Yeah. And this is, you're never gonna use this. This is for co-op. So R1 is your light attack, R2 is your heavy attack, L1 is your block, and L2 is what they call an Ash of War. It's basically your special move for this weapon. Each weapon has a special move attached to it. For this one, it's really strong. It's called Unsheath. If you keep L2 pressed, you'll go into L2, not Yes. Okay, so yeah. If you hold that, you have now two options. Either that's one of them, or you do the yes. So these are attacks that are really strong, but if you notice your mana bar at the top, it depleted your mana bar. So you can't do these infinitely. one extra thing that might be annoying to you is if you hold the triangle button and press R1, you can two-hand your weapon. And two-handing the weapon makes it now when you attack, he's attacking with two hands. It switches out the moveset. So this is, you're going to be using that button a lot. That is your, you're going to have a healing potion there. And yeah. Yeah. So do you feel compelled to explore, or should I push you forward? Yeah. Yes. You can play offline if you want to turn those off. And these are phantoms of players that are currently. When someone dies, they leave a bloodstain showing how they died. So it's like a warning of beware, people died like this. Don't just jump. Yes. Yeah. So yeah, a lot of online people put messages to be a bit trolly. That's the Erd tree. The Erd tree. You'll learn about it. Yeah. All right. Do you wanna get a little surprise, or should I warn you about what's coming ahead? Set you up for success. Yes. So So you're going to cross the bridge and you're going to be met with an enemy that's designed to overpower you. Some people can beat it, but it's not easy. It's supposed to like set the tone of like this game's going to crush you. So just use this as an opportunity to, you know, try the controls. And yeah. Well, yeah. If you want, you can like play offline and then you won't have to. And you'll die. Yeah, if you hold the dodge button. The circle. All right, are you ready to meet your fate? All right, if you click the right stick, you lock on to enemies. He smacked you around. Yeah, because you didn't dodge his attack. Yeah, it's they set the tone immediately. He yelled. Look, they're setting the tone. They're telling you like you're not worthy. Get good. So this is basically like a scripted death. Even if you beat that first boss, you get to a point where a bridge just falls apart and kills you. Yeah. You're not that even like you're not a special person, you're just one of the kind that could be special. You mean capture? Like, I don't think this is mocap. I think this is animated. Not a lot. You're looking for cutscenes? Yeah, not a lot. All right, so this is your healing potion. And this is your mana potion. Now there's a piece that everybody misses, which is the tutorial. You have to drop, you see where that a ghost is sitting? You have to drop there. Cave of Knowledge. You can't hit circle. This is the only time you should like trust the fall. Okay, now they're telling you to. Okay. You see that little sparkle? I don't know why I'm pointing. See that little sparkle over there? that is your like save checkpoint. So whenever you save, your healing potions replenish, your mana potions replenish, everything replenishes, but every enemy you killed beyond bosses respawn. So like it's like you're undoing your progress to heal. So you can't be like, okay, I'll kill this one, come back, heal, kill the other one, come back, heal. No, you have to go through. The colloquialism is get good. Careful to the to your left, there's an enemy. All right. So if you wanna, if you click on that, first of all, remember you took a golden seed. Golden seeds add more charges to your healing. So like add charge. Yep. So now you upgraded your healing potion inventory. If you go to allocate flask charges, if you don't wanna, so you can choose your five total potions, how many are for hit points and how many are. So I feel this 5-0 is good. You can no leave. Yeah. So there's a stamina system you'll get acquainted to. You can't swing forever. Like at some point, you can't swing anymore until you stop swinging. And also dodging uses stamina. So let's say you swung your sword too much. Now you want to dodge, you can't. You got to balance. So you should get into the habit of clicking the right stick to lock on. So guarding is with L1. How do the controls feel for now? So it's the circle. Yeah, anytime you see an enemy, get in the habit of clicking the right analog stick to lock onto them. Or else you'll use full now. This is not Zelda. So yeah. Someone's shooting. Usually you can find enemies by locking on them. Like if they're in range. So here they're teaching you if you hold triangle and use click R1, then you're two-handing your weapon. lock onto him so you can see what's happening. Now you have to get through. Yeah, if you lock onto him, you can strafe now. So like if you go side to side, he does a circle around him. So, like you, all enemies have stamina. And if you deplete that with your attacks, then they break their guard. There's one like on your tail. I thought I saw it. Yeah, that's their way. Right. And remember, this is still a tutorial. Yeah, you should get into the habit of blocking immediately, or else you run the risk of not hitting your attack. No, just messages. Yeah. Yeah, lock onto. I wouldn't bother with that. So I hear you like fiercely tapping. That will get you killed. Yeah, this is teaching you to use the L2 one. You wanna try it? Well, this I wouldn't unleash it right now. It's the kill. Crouching. Your crouch is with the left. If you click the left stick. You can backstab. By the way, if you position yourself right behind while crouched and long press the R1, you'll do back. You have to be crouched. Yeah, lock on. Get closer. You have to touch him. So basically they're telling you to do a charge heavy attack. That way you can like break somebody. Take America is like a, not a checkpoint, but it's a place where if you die, you can choose to respawn there. Usually when you see one, it means there's a boss. This didn't exist in previous games. Like you had to run a long time from checkpoint. No, this one, no. Just if you're in its presence. Yep. Behold, soldier of Godric. This is a normal enemy, just as a boss, just to teach you about stuff. So no pressure, but this is a tutorial boss. If you die here. Careful, your green bar, it shouldn't deplete. Good job. Yeah, you see that green bar? If it depletes, yeah. When you stop doing anything, it refills quickly. But like if you're, you can't, like you can't dodge, you can't attack. But as soon as you stop, it refills. So it's like, it just stops. we're back here. Yeah, there's gestures for online play. You got your first gesture. Yeah. So now you can jump off here. Yeah, you should dismiss this. Yep, that's where you jump. There you go. Checkpoint. Yeah, you can ignore the co-op piece. So, this is an elevator, and it's activated using that middle button on it. So you have to stand on it. It'll click. It'll go up. We have one viewer, and I believe it's Bill. Hey, Bill. So when you do that, you sent the elevator, but here we are. You're gonna be unleashed. So this is the start area, Limgrave. So NPCs are very far and few between. This guy quickly became a meme online. You are maidenless is like the new, like, no B words. And you know, expressions like maidenless behavior are catching on. So as I'm backseat gaming, I have to point out that the knight that you're seeing there is not easy to beat. So I would you usually like skip past him, get a few upgrades, come back. Yeah, they introduced an unnecessary item crafting system. Yeah. There's no encumbrance, so like you can pick up literally everything. But like when the stuff you equip is the stuff that affects your carry weight. So you can have like, so if you look up, beyond the knight, there's like a church. That's where. Yeah, and you can sprint using. Well, you're going too far around him. So previous games, they were very railroaded, and if you hit a wall, well, you went too wide. Yeah, just because in that church, you might get a first upgrade, so it'll help you out a bit. No, you can go straight there. You can. So if you use a lot of arrows, you have to kill like critters to get their bones to make them. Yeah, to the church to the right. Yeah. Yep, right there. That's a friendly. Your currency is runes. It's used both as currency and as experience points. And when you die, any unused currency will drop on the floor. And then you have to go back and pick it up before you die again. Because if you do die again, those points are gone. That sounds fun. So here, I suggest you get the crafting kit. You have enough for it. Yeah. And I would get also the torch for later. You can leave him now. Look behind him, behind you. There's a. Yep, that. Yeah, they're telling you that you can upgrade your weapons. This weapon is really good. So like it's safe to use this stone. So smithing stone one is like for the first level of upgrades. And so you need two of these to be able to get your first upgrade. Two of these stones. In the world might drop from enemies. So now that you're on the, it's telling you now you can fast travel between checkpoints. Yeah. And you see this like little comet coming out of the checkpoint. This is telling you like this is the general direction that you need to be going for the next progression. Yeah, you can take him. Yeah, if you want to backstab, you have to touch him and yep. Yeah, so as you can notice, backstabs are really good. Like, and that, you know, like obelisk there has a map, so the map won't be gray, it will be populated with stuff. Now, soon you'll get an. Yeah, if you break their stance, you can also like front stab. But you should get in the habit of like locking, clicking the right stick, because you could have easily missed. So these are throwing knives. I won't complicate it for you. you should. Oh, also, your weapon has bleed on it. So like after an X amount of hits, you can. Like you'll see them, they'll lose a lot of HP. Suddenly, I don't know. By the way, this guy dropped his chest piece. So like if this were like better than your chest piece, you can definitely like switch it up. You want some guidance where to go? Got him. Thing got him. So, general direction is towards there. That's a joke. There's one of the starting classes, a thief. He has a dagger, and he's really, like, daggers are really good at backstabs. Oh, yeah, lock onto this, sprint at it, and start attacking. So, whenever you see one of these, they drop some really good. Well, this one did, but usually they drop like upgrade material, or they drop like ashes of war, so you can change the special attack on your weapon. Yeah, that's an ingredient for like a poison class. All right, so you stand here and like scan there, you see a twinkle next to the gate of that. Castle, that's your next checkpoint. Like, yeah. So I would suggest that you stealth there, get the checkpoint, and then engage with the enemies in this game. 'Cause strong enemies. Strong for your level. You have a jump button. We should figure out if there's a mod that gives you a PlayStation prompt. So when you touch it once, you didn't really, you just like acquired it, but you need to sit down to like rest. Yeah. So now you can use runes to level up. So now you can summon. Can you go to the settings? Because we can at least toggle Xbox controls instead of keyboard. Sure, yeah. So you don't have enough for level up, but I suggest Vigor as your first upgrade, because that increases your health. Yeah. If you go to, yeah, now they're telling you how to summon Torrent. So if you go to system, go to controller, not this one, the other one. Might be the first tab gameplay. Let me make sure. One of them, you Can you yes. It's still an Xbox, but it's not giving you like computer PC stuff. So to summon Torrent, you press triangle and down on the D-pad. Oh, you have an equipment. So go to your equipment to the side. No, you see on the right, there's like four like slots. You don't need any. So now if you hold triangle, you'll see now down on the D-pad, you summon Torrent. And Torrent can sprint and can double jump. And you can have mounted combat. Yeah, but it you have to switch up the way you think about it. Now, right one is attacking from the right side of the horse, and L1 is attacking from the left side. You have to choose which side you're attacking, and you can do also heavy attacks. Yeah, he drags the sword. On the horse, you still have stamina, by the way. And if you get dismounted from the horse, you get stunned. So, like, you're vulnerable. Yeah, you have to click left stick. So that carriage. Yeah. So that. That little carriage, there's a chest. So that's a two-handed greatsword. You can use it one-handed, but you need a lot of strength to do that. So if you like. This is a case where they offer you a lot of like options, and if you don't like what you chose for the start, you can equip that and try it out. You don't have to replace it. You don't have the required stats to wield it. So. Yeah. Look, I've seen a lot of people finish the game with this katana. See this guy with a trumpet? He rallies the troops. You might want to kill him first. You might want to lock. Must be the wind. So that knight that won't clad in armor, he's really hard. Yeah. Oh, you see that little monolith in the front? It has a map. You only have to pick it up once. Behind you. Yeah, to the left. There's like a stone. Yeah, that. In front of it. On the other side of it. Literally. So now you have a detailed map of this area. So if you don't kill guys, you'll never like upgrade. And you need to get used to the fighting. So I would kill guys. Don't forget to lock. Yes, you can. That big guy, if he's guarding and you hit him, he does a counterattack. Yeah, don't forget to lock on. Yeah, you need to lock on. They can hit them. Careful on your stamina. You might want to heal this one. Press square. This is a piece that only happens in the open world. So because you killed a specific group, it replenishes your healing potions. Yeah. Dogs are annoying. You might want to whip out your shield. Yep, and block them. Yeah, lock onto them, and keep the block open. After they attack and get blocked, you attack. You can't backstab them. Careful, dog. I will block. Like, lock on. Lock on. Yeah. But you should lock on, or else the block won't be in the right direction. So you notice they're guarding like an entrance to an underground thing. So basically, you found Stormstomp. Right now you have Unsheath. You can remove Unsheath and put Warstomp if you want. But that that's basically the system of like choosing which special attack you want. And the Whetstone can help you change, like, this katana right now is good for like dexterity, like the stat dexterity. So like you can change it to become like a heavy katana, and then it, instead of scaling with dex, it scales with strength. So like you can try to adapt the weapon to your build to some extent, but some weapons fare better in a certain type than another. So this guy, I would suggest that you lock on. Then follow it up with a yep, dodge. Yeah, you have to lock on. That was close. That was really close. All right. I would suggest that you, that's another checkpoint. That's the only place that that's like two checkpoints. Yeah. Now you have enough to get a level. How are you feeling about the fighting? Well, my wife beat Dark Souls 3 Bloodborne, but she wasn't skilled before and she's skilled now. So you can do it. Yeah, for now. So this increases your HP. You can take more hits. But now you're going to notice that if you turn around, everybody's alive again. If you go to the side, there's another caravan that has another weapon, flail. You might as well just pick it up behind you. Yep. That's not the one. Yeah, there's two guys there. You can sneak on. You should lock on one of them so you can like run away while looking at them. And if you want to switch targets, you flick your you're not getting game audio, Jeff. How about now? How about now? I know, right? It's one of my favorite games in recent history. Is Jeff. Yeah, we have that. I guess not. No, Bill's not. Bill's not here anymore. Yeah.
Somebody saw me.
Thank you, Jeff. Can hear him now.
How about now?
Yeah, he should be able to.
Okay, that's good.
We need a lot of training, Jeff. This stuff. That's why we're doing gaming stuff to test out.
Yep. Onward.
Right.
Stormgate. Right. Okay. All right. All right. Backseat gamer. We'll help you. Jesus.
Well,
some sniper shots over
here. I would suggest you heal and summon your horse and just gun.
Ah, okay. And that is triangle down. Just gun it past him.
Yeah. Yep. Def told you just be good.
Seed, baby.
Jeff, I had just told Chris, my wife, upskilled, got good, beat Bloodborne, Dark Souls 3, still hasn't done Dark Souls 1. You can get good. Anyone can get good.
Oh, Jesus.
Yep, keep going. So while you're on the horse, yeah, you can pick up stuff. So I would suggest you go past that golden tree and pick up the golden seed.
That's terrible timing.
Yep. I suggest you save here. Yeah, get the checkpoint. Get the checkpoint. Jump off. Get the checkpoint, yep. Quick.
Just
keep mashing triangle roll. Oh, okay. That was rough.
I died.
How does
Not
it feel?
Not right away.
First death.
Lasted longer than I thought I would.
All right. So now you're learning that you just dropped 700 runes. You have to go grab them back.
From my death spot?
Yeah.
Okay, I can handle that. All right, triangle down. Pretty good at jumping over these things. Side here with these dogs.
Yeah, did you grab that?
What?
Did you grab the thing next to there? Yeah, you did. on your compass up top, it shows you like where's the general direction. And retrieve them with now dismount and you have to dismount. Not that. left.
There we go.
Yep, that one.
Flasks.
Yeah, because you just picked up another one. I have six. Can you level up?
This tiny golden aura is the grace of the Earth Tree. This light once shone in the eye, but now it is all we can see.
I know, right? In fact, earlier games were even easier, like less buttons. They started combining buttons. You have to combine triangle and like a couple of buttons to do some shortcuts because there's not enough stuff to enough buttons to go around.
Your thoughts. Upon the cliff in Castle Stormvale, a demigod who inherited a fragment of the shell. If the rays of grace signal the call, then the Elden Ring beckons. As an ally, I pray that you are fit to face the challenge.
Chris skipping story.
I'm not fit. I'm not fit to face this challenge.
So if you turn around, there's a gal.
A gal? Oh, in here?
Yeah, Death's not liking you meshing for the lore.
Been grafted. Everyone who came with me. They crossed the
no,
sea
they
for me. They fought for me. Only to have their arms taken.
Well, I have some insight.
Their legs taken. Even their head
for her.
Taken.
Yeah, she's special.
She's special.
To the spider. Did you know? If you're grafted by the spider, you become a chrysalid.
My favorite.
It's quite a lark when you think about it.
Such a lark. Yes, sitting yeah, sideways.
Keep talking.
You're all on your own, are you?
No.
Heading to
I'm not maidless.
Enticed by the white mask, I suppose.
Jeff, you missed the maidenless part. He got called maidenless like twice.
I don't have your courage. It's scary, you know, having your arms cut off, or legs, or your head.
Yeah, that sounds scary.
I want to be like everyone else, but I'm just too scared. I'm nothing but a craven.
Got that right.
Keep talking.
No. Can you take this little one along
what?
With you?
Spirit jellyfish ashes.
So in this game,
someone braver than
you can summon ashes that, like spirits to assist. It's a big controversial element of the game for purists. Purists are like, oh no, I don't summon help because I'm good and I don't need the help. And other people are like, oh, I beat the game. I use spirits.
All day long.
Everybody's like, you did technically beat it. And there's this whole discourse about, well, it's in the game. You should be able to use it.
It was a pleasure to see you.
Okay, you're good. Yeah, oh. Just need
can you pass on a message for me? If you see the little chrysalids in Stormvale Castle, tell them I love them. And that, despite my craven heart, I'm sure I'm finally getting the hang of this whole pain thing, you know?
Except you're not.
It was a pleasure to see you. Oh, tell them I finally get
so, an insight you don't have, I would suggest you teleport back to the first church we got.
Govern myself to step beyond the bounds of this world. Please.
Can I get this thing first?
No, anyways.
He's open. Like, these are consumable keys that are placed in my life.
Is good luck another inside joke?
No. Your gun.
Alright.
I would,
Alright, so teleport. Yeah, Matt.
I will, go to Church of LA. Yeah, that one. Not. Being summoned
by this lady. I thought you said the NPCs were too few and far between.
Sorry. And I told you to come here. Lena,
I'd heard tell of a tarnished hurtling about atop a spectral steed, and upon looking
sweet
into
hat.
The matter, the talk I surmised.
You can get that.
Awesome.
After long.
Power, no.
It's like
to
a
call forth the spectral steed.
Giant VV hat. I can call the spectral steed.
My wife just sent me a screenshot of her playing Baldur's Gate with 30 corpses.
I hoped. I was entrusted this for thee by Torrent's former master.
So, we came here for the bell.
She has
that's
four
the,
arms.
Yeah. That's okay. The bell that helps you summon. So now you can either summon the jellyfish or the...
It's a bell for calling forth spirits. Summon them with it. From ash, and the spirits will obey thine command, but briefly. As they recall battles past, now it is thine to do with as thou wishest.
So now if you go to your inventory...
Intrusion tarnished. I doubt we shall again meet. But all the same, learn well the lands between.
Trying to get all the lore here for Jeff.
Before the tarnished tire of obeisance to the two fingers.
There she goes.
There she goes.
All right, inventory, you said?
Yeah. If you go to the right next to the seed, shortcut.
The right next to the steed.
To the right, the right menu. Yeah, you can equip the wolves.
And not the jellyfish?
Yeah, the wolves. So now, whenever you're in a place and to the left, you get a little icon that's like a gate, you can summon these wolves.
Okay.
And I'll let you know. It's mostly during boss. Yeah, there's no reference.
Alright.
So you can teleport back to the foremost back.
You may occasionally see faint white phantoms.
I would jump on the student.
Triangle down. It's pointing me that way, right?
It's kind
but
of
I gotta follow the path.
Yeah, it's like at least.
Yeah. It's going like this. Go like that.
Yep.
And just gun it till when?
You'll know. Till the next checkpoint.
Okay. Oh. That's not gunning it, is it?
Oh, that's better.
I thought I could swipe one of the guys.
Keep going. Any other time, I would tell you to kill that.
Oh, gosh.
First thing you do, press square.
Oh,
He didn't.
I did. I press square.
Yeah, choose Take America.
In the chest.
Yeah, so maybe get on the steed, go pick the soul's bat and like your runes, and try to go to the left away from the catapult. I know your stuff. If you die now, you lose 700 something.
Right, where is the stuff?
Here.
Right here?
Yeah.
Oh. The triangle. So where am I going?
Yeah, just to the left. Hug the wall so you can get behind the catapult. Yeah, to the right. Yeah, just hug the wall here. Yep. Roll. To the left, the first crevice. There should be a... I would rest here. Jeff, the fun begins now. You'll see why.
Because I get to talk to Melina again.
Me? I'm searching for my purpose, given to me by my mother inside the Erd Tree, long ago, for the reason that I yet live, burned and bodiless. There is something for which I must apologize. I've acted the finger maiden, yet can offer no guidance. I am no maiden. My purpose was long ago lost.
Deep.
Shall I turn your rune? Let my share them with me.
Oh, so close.
Your thoughts.
Your if you kill one extra guy.
The principles. Mm-hmm.
All right, now what?
And not here. Go back. Kill one extra guy. Level up. Get the first phase. Okay, you see this thing to the left? The little gate that showed up?
Yeah.
This is when you can summon spirits.
Okay. Yeah, this
one. Locked on. See? You have to lock on. Run away. Run away. Go back.
Go back where?
Yeah, here. If you go safe to the checkpoint, it despawns. Jeff's saying use Z targeting. I would level up Vigor as well. All right. Fun begins now. Let's see you have the mental fortitude for this.
I don't.
All right. No. Nothing ominous. Promise. This is a like summon cooperator. I would try it first for that.
Alright, give me the strategy here.
Strategy is don't get hit. No, I'm serious. This is like there's no special sauce. It's just keep watching and pick your spots. When he He gets ready to swing at you. Get ready to dodge. And after you dodge, you hit. Don't hit too much.
Shut your mouth.
In search of the Elden Ring.
Is there any other?
Emboldened by the flame of ambition.
Just trying to survive. It's excessive. Must be Margit.
All right, lock on. Dodge.
Oh, I meant to dodge.
Yeah, you can't preemptively dodge. Don't forget your healing.
So just keep dodging.
Until, but dodge into him. Don't dodge away from him, dodge into him.
Okay.
So, we leveled up just before you started, so it's fine. If you lose like 50.
Right.
So yeah, this is what you're up against. This is the first boss. This is the quote-unquote easiest boss. Always make sure to lock on him.
Jesus.
Nice. Attack. When he's in that, hey. Nice. Okay, see? You have the instinct. But don't overroll. Like, when he's not attacking, don't roll. Yeah, don't preemptively roll. And don't forget to heal. Yeah, that was preemptive. No, you got it. You have the instinct.
Right.
Don't sell yourself short.
Over under. Jeff. Yeah. How many tries?
My wife's saying she feels your pain. After a couple of tries, I can jump in with you and help you out.
I hit circle.
Nice. How are you feeling?
Only one way to get better.
I have to admit, I've never like raged in previous games, but not here. But some instances in this game, I caught myself like almost checking control. What?
I'm not. Buttons are not. They're taking a while to.
Yeah.
The button schematics are not what I'm used to. Calm down.
Yep.
Come on.
These foolish ambitions to rest.
Are you gonna put these foolish ambitions to rest? Don't forget to heal.
Yeah. Come on.
That's good. Careful of your stamina. You can't roll away if you're don't have stamina. So you have to choose between pouring a bit of stamina for rolling or doing the last thing.
Alright, one more try.
Just one.
Before I call you in.
These foolish ambitions to rest.
How are you feeling?
Not enjoying myself.
This is not me. This is do you want to try? So, do you know what's the shortcut for your wolf? The triangle left?
That's right.
You want to try the wolves? See what happens?
Yeah.
Get the wolves. So my suggestion is call the wolves and wait. Let them attack first. Distract them and then go.
Okay.
Come on, you can do this.
He's not down with that plan.
The wolves are meant to like distract you. So if you unequip your shield and use the L2 with heavy attack, it's really effective. But you have to be close. Yeah.
That's not what I wanted to do. Did you dodge already? God damn it.
Alright. I'm here to help.
Ambitions are resting.
Look for a gold sign. Oh wait, before I need you to go to settings. multiplayer. Choose group password. Oh, you haven't set it. I guess in the settings. Oh yeah, set the first group password as Chris. Should you look down? Let me place it somewhere else, next to the checkpoint. Try resting, see what happens.
Forgive me. I've been testing you to see whether or not grace truly does guide you.
Thank you.
Whether you are fit to face the challenge that entails. It seems my worries were unfounded.
Oh, is that right?
Torrent, from the very start. Whereas I merely pretended. There is but one other thing I can do to offer you guidance. I can take you to the Round Table Hole.
Let's do it.
Gathering place of tarnished champions, guided by grace.
Can you close?
So don't go here.
Yeah. Leave. Okay, on the left side of the gate.
The summoning pool is now functional.
Group that. Then the cooperative sounds nice. Okay. Yeah, try that.
I'm into another world. Now. What?
Okay. I hope you didn't get summoned to my world. Somebody summoned you to their game.
How do I leave?
So if you press your menu, go to multiplayer. Yeah, that the second one. Not the top one. Okay, choose that.
I mean, if that guy's naked, maybe I should watch him. Must be pretty good.
You have something called pearl calling. Pearl calling finger.
Pearl calling.
Okay, you should go to round table hold and get a.
Yeah, that's why she wants me to go there. She's like, bitch, you need some help. I have been watching you. Well, I think you're fit. You definitely need to go get help.
Very well. Let my hand rest upon you.
So much touching. Shazam!
Yeah, she's taking you to her hub. So this is like the base. And I would suggest that you go to the left side door. Go to the right. Yeah, this is the vendor here on the right. Purchase. Okay.
So I can't even call you for help.
So you can go back.
Just make sure I don't have this thing.
No, you don't.
So this creates a summon sign.
Yeah.
So I can't summon you with that?
No, because you put down a sign for you to get summoned.
I press this one. I think I just pressed the wrong one.
Yeah, this is like general, like match make me with someone. The one we're looking for is to get me specifically. But you should be able to see my summon sign. Unless I have. Can you go into the settings? Maybe you have. Not. Yeah, Mabel. No matchmaking. All right, you can teleport back. Yeah. It could be that I'm too high level. All right, go to the gate. I should have a. Yeah, touch the. I just put a new one. You know what? Try it with the other guy. That's it.
gonna take me like an hour. And the wolves I can summon?
Yeah.
Alright.
Doing all right. Yep. Careful. Jump. Warrior blood must. Your dogs are dead. So if you don't have mana, that attack doesn't do much. Okay.
It's only half dead. Alright.
Jesus. This was better. No?
They did all the work.
No.
Alright. So. Okay.
There's a specific item I'm looking up how you can get it so you can get me.
So I just need to like rerun the whole first set of enemies like 10 times?
Oh, wait, can you look at crafting? Oh, yeah, this thing.
You said it wasn't important.
Well, I wasn't planning on
saving my ass so quickly. You thought wrong.
Now go to multiplayer. And break it. Use it. Should be to your left. Let me see if I get a weaker character.
I'm gonna try it while you do that. All right.
You can do this.
What the hell? Wolves, damn it.
Why? For some reason you can't. Wolves? Not sure why.
Heal.
Heal, yeah. You can do it.
So you're in here?
Okay, now it worked. Oh no, this is not me.
Alright. Focus. Oh no, he's still got like 3/4 life. Whatever. I thought he was like closer.
Well.
Alright.
Thou art of passing skill. Warrior blood.
But you can do this, you have enough healing. Should lock on. And you...
I keep wanting to press square. Like, I need to change attack to square. So can I?
Let me see if I can do that now.
Because I probably wasted the.
The thing, yeah. Well, if you manage to summon me once, I can drop you a bunch.
Oh, I just need to get some flowers. All right, let me grind a little bit. Backstab.
How much runes do you have? You have 1,000. The first merchant we met in the church sells one.
Is that 184?
Yeah. Runes?
Yeah. I just need to go get some flowers.
If you're done, it's okay.
No, that's not how I roll. There's a guy right here, right?
Hey, don't forget to lock. So,
yeah.
If you open your map, Jesus. Don't open your mouth. You're in combat, you know. I guess you gotta rush. Just lock onto him and sprint at him. New map now. Yeah, go back to Treasure Cellar. Yep, right around there. There's a bunch of can you open the map? Yeah, there's around here. By the way, you can put waypoints if you want on the map.
Okay. Right.
So let us figure out where you can summon me so I can drop you the rest.
Yeah. It's like right here.
So can you go back to if you open the map, there's a checkpoint. Yeah, the first step. I'll go there as well. You should be able to summon me. Let me get there. No, right there, man. Right next to it.
Right.
Can you crack one the finger? Also, what's that next to the NPC? Right. Yeah, crack that one finger. Should be like. You have the. Can you make sure you have the little. Okay. Go closer to the ledge. until you get the sign that shows you that you can summon the wolf. If you can't summon the wolves, you can't summon the wolves. Go down to the ledge. Go back to the checkpoint, and there's like a little here, like to your right. Examine. Who's that? No, don't.
Is that you?
No. What about that? Keep checking the yellow one. No, not. What about the other one? I'm in. Right behind. Place it. Kind of frustrating.
Is this you?
It could be that I'm not allowed to.
How about this guy?
You have the Chris message.
You mean the group password?
Yeah.
Do I need a multiplayer password?
Might as well. Can you put it the same?
If you set a multiplayer password, you'll only be matched with other players using the same password.
Yeah, do that. Should see a summon sign behind. Let me put it right there. Effigy. Could show up right there.
Well, there we go.
Huh.
Is that you?
Yeah.
All right.
We figured it out. Here's what's going to happen. I'm going to drop you 30 of these. I'm coming.
Maybe.
Can't I drop? What if I drop you there? We invaded. Gotcha. Somebody's invading us. What?
Jesus.
What was it? Can you see him?
Okay. It's over here. Yeah.
Right, I got him. Oh, he's annoying.
Did you get him?
Not yet. He's very elusive.
Should I try to kill him too?
Well, he'll kill you quickly. Oh, that's a thing. Yeah. Okay, he killed me. Sorry about that.
Now he's gonna kill me.
Yeah. He can't.
Welcome to Elden Ring.
Kind of, yes.
That's a thing.
Yeah, if you summon help, then you also open yourself up for invasion. I feel that's your
unwarranted PvP.
Yeah.
I love it.
I feel that's your limit for this session.
No. We're gonna get the job done.
So, I can't drop you the stuff. If you can grab another tree leaf and meet me in front of the boss, we can do this. And not this one.
I'm just looking for leaves.
It's around the Church of Power. In fact, the same one you found before. Should be able to find it. What's that on your right? Hey.
I need two. You
need two per?
No, okay.
Oh yeah, you have two.
Okay. So.
Go teleport to You have to craft. Yep, that's me. Guy's going down.
Alright.
By the way, he gets more HP the more people you summon.
Right. Because Because why not?
Oh, it's the balance.
Yeah.
Oh, and my life gets cut in half. Yeah. Too high level.
Should I still bring the wolves?
You can. Ready?
Ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why won't it let me bring the wolves?
Because I'm here. Careful, don't die.
Wow. So all the ledges are
yes.
open.
Yeah.
And now I need another leaf. Weak foe ahead.
Let me go grab another character now that we know that this works.
Well, that was your underpowered character.
Well, that was the they kind of like lower my stats and level to be like kind of equivalent to yours. So right. Whatever character I get,
I can't backstab this guy.
You might want to go farm some, get another
flower.
Yeah, in the same place. I wonder is why I can't drop you the items required. You cannot. Oh, but I can drop you the flowers. I have them. So all you need is just the one. I'll drop you all the flowers you have.
Okay. You have been summoned.
You have the thing? Did you pop the finger?
Yep.
Should be next to the FB.
I should, should I save?
Sure.
monkey. Yeah. Nice.
Grab you a bunch of leaves.
Now we smoke this fool.
Yeah.
Put me out of my misery. Pick up item. 43 leaves, baby. Alright.
Are you ready?
Let's do it.
Oh man, I fell.
Nice.
That was sorry. But hey, got to have. Good luck. This time I won't fall.
Oh man.
Now you have enough to leave, right? Oh wait, I think you still have the thing.
No.
You have an aura.
Alright, it would be under my bar. Like, watch. See, now it's under the bar.
Right under you.
Yep. Give it a second.
Show up in the corner. Yep. Wrong.
Yeah, I just wanted a piece of the action from the first time.
Well, must truly run in thy veins.
Hey, Bill, yeah, we're still at it.
Oh, God.
No, oh, don't God. Die, don't die, don't die, don't die, don't die, don't die. Don't die.
Jesus. First boss done, Bill.
With no help at all.
Jesus. Why? Why this game?
The hands of the fell omen shall brook thee no quarter.
Like, how many times do you fight that guy before you beat him?
Me?
Yeah.
So, have my wife as a witness.
What?
How many times does it take?
The first time you played the game.
Well, I watched her try it 20 times.
I tried it. Oh, okay. It's different when you're in it.
But there are some bosses that took like 30.
Oh shit. 9,000.
Yeah. So here's right. what I suggest. Two vigor. Two deck. And one endurance. Another deck. Right.
Okay. I'd be all in on strength if you were there.
Well, this build specifically. You feel you're at a point where you can stop. Too much adrenaline for one session.
I'm gonna kill something myself.
This was the easiest spot.
I know.
Well, thanks you guys for coming. This was Chris trying his best at Elden Ring.
time for the Minecraft nightcap.
Right.
Can barely handle those guys. Little big old dudes.